So we are about to leave this world for a little bit because here is Professor Anders Ynnerman.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to address you for a little while this afternoon. And I will do that together with my colleague, my technical support, dear friend and space pilot, Alexander Bock. And he's sitting right in the booth over there, and he will be guiding us through the universe today. Now, space is the topic of my talk, and space has been a source of fascination, imagination, and innovation for mankind all through its history. But it really took a giant leap back in the 1960s. The space race was on, catalyzed by the Cold War. Back in those days, things were progressing rapidly. And ultimately, in 1969, on the 20th of July, 50 years ago, Neil Armstrong landed on the moon and the United States had won the space race. I was then 6 years old. And over here is a television set. It's my grandmother's old television set. I was watching TV 24/7 while this was happening, and I decided immediately that I wanted to become an astronaut. To the point that Christmas 1969, they gave me a space helmet. And you know, I refused to take this off for weeks at end. They had to feed me sandwiches through the visor. That was the only way that I could be fed as the young astronaut. This was a source of inspiration, and as you heard, my PhD in quantum theory took its very beginning back in 1969. Wouldn't it be great if we could go back in time and relive these magical moments in the history of mankind from 1968 and 69? But guess what? We can. With the help of visualization, I can pronounce visualization, and graphics, and data. We are now back in 1968 with the help of our software, OpenSpace, and this is the 21st of December 1968, Apollo 8, and the first spacecraft to leave Earth with humans and heading towards the moon. We have three very brave men on the spacecraft, and they are arriving at the moon 3 days later, on Christmas Eve, 1968. This is the trajectory from NASA. We have been digging through the archives and the actually real data. So what you're seeing is real data visualization. There's nothing fake in here. Donald Trump would hate this. It's all real data and visualization that you're looking at. And now we are here. Look. With the help of data from the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, Alex is now driving space for us, and we put ourselves, we're piggybacking on Apollo 8. The three astronauts are here. We have Jim Lovell, we have Frank Borman, and William Anders sitting right here. They are orbiting the moon, and for the first time, humans can, with their own eyes, see the backside of the moon, and their mission was to take pictures of the backside of the moon. Let's listen to the guys when they're talking.
Oh my God, look at that picture over there. There's the Earth coming up. Wow, is that pretty. Hey, don't take that, it's not scheduled.
Did you hear that?
I got a phrase that's very clear right here.
Did you hear what he just said? He said, don't take that picture, it's not scheduled. They were not supposed to take pictures of the Earth, but they did because it was such a beautiful view. For the first time, humans saw the Earth rising over the horizon of the moon. And look at the picture up there. That's the picture they took. And it matches. No, conspiracy theory people out there, this is a piece of evidence. Look at the horizon, it matches. It matches the data that we have acquired from the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter and where we are right in place on the moon. And we are following Apollo 8 in its accurate trajectory, calculated by hand and with very simple computers back in 1968. I'm also very proud to say that the picture up there that just disappeared was taken with a Swedish Hasselblad camera. The Swedish contribution to space exploration. All right. The Apollo missions continued, and there were many missions to different places, and you all know that we accumulated lots of information, and the 20th of July 1969, Neil Armstrong landed on the moon. But I'm not going to go there. I'm not going to go to the landing site of Apollo. It's pretty boring. It's the safest place on the moon. It's flat, and nothing exciting is going on. But we are going to go to Apollo 17. That is the latest, I refrain from saying the last, the latest place on the moon that humans have visited. And we're now here with real data. We're in the valley for Apollo 17. We're in the Taurus Litter Valley. And Apollo 17, we're going down. Alex, can you bring us down? Let's see if we can find the landing site. Let's see if we can find it somewhere. Now look at the terrain that you're seeing. It's all real data that we have acquired. We have extracted the topography, and we can freely fly around on the site where they landed. Here, you can even see the traces of the lunar rover and the footprints from the astronauts. So here's pretty good evidence. Now, Alex, turn on the traversal map for me. We even have information. They took the lunar rover and they drove 35 kilometers around and away. And look, we are flying up towards the North Massive up here. Go up to point 6 for me, please, Alex. You can see how they have extracted information about the geology. And look at these pictures up here. The pictures that were taken right in the place where we are right now. And this is the most amazing way of documenting the evolution of space missions that you're looking at now. These pictures are taken right down there. This is the rock you're seeing, the boulder rock right up there. It's taken right where we are now. And we can fly back thanks to our software, OpenSpace. Where are we heading in the future? We've been to the moon. Some people say we're going back. I would like to go back. But Mars is, of course, the mission where we're going now. So Alex, let's take us to Mars. Here's Mars. Mars is a red planet. And many, many spacecrafts have been orbiting the planet for many years and taking pictures. And now it's real data, data that is not sitting here. It's sitting on a server on the internet in Utah. And we have data from all these missions. We're bringing in data from a camera called the CTX camera, the context camera on the MRO. Look, it's coming in over the internet. And we're zooming in into the 6 meter resolution of the Martian surface. So Alex, bring us down. We're going into the Valles Marineris. It's the most amazing part of Mars. If you get a ticket to Mars, go to Valles Marineris. I can recommend that. And there's one favorite place of mine called the Southwestern Candor Chasma. Remember that. Now we're heading down here. Look down here. The 6 meter resolution. We're virtually landing on the surface of Mars. We're going down into the patch where there's another instrument on the MRO called the high-rise camera. And the high-res camera has 25 centimeter resolution. We are now virtually down on the Martian surface. The sand dunes you're seeing, they're maybe 50 meters in altitude. And we're down to the human scale. I promise you, if Matt Damon was here, we would see him at this point. This, for me, is the ultimate way of using visualization data that we are acquiring to visit places that are very difficult to go to, or even impossible, long before we can send humans here. And it's my hope that in the same way that I was inspired by Neil Armstrong, by the Apollo program back in the 1960s, that maybe the children of today will be inspired by the virtual exploration that we can provide them with not only the surface of Mars, but the whole universe, is available through our software, OpenSpace, and the best thing is that it's open source. So if you like what you see here, go back home tonight, grab your kids' computers, and download OpenSpace, and you can do exactly what I did here. I can't think of a better place to leave you on a Friday afternoon, you're probably all very tired, than on the surface of Mars. And Alex, can you give them a very nice sunset on Mars, please? I think they would like that. So, farewell, Mars. Thank you very much, all brilliant minds. And thank you to Alex for coding the software and being right over there. Give him a nice hand as well.